You've been asking for it, and here it is. Bluetooth capabilities are now available with our MMI Prime and Pro with our newest update. Welcome back, I'm Dylan with Beamer Tech. By now, you know all about our wireless CarPlay and Android Auto MMI Prime and Pro. It's the best way to integrate Apple CarPlay and Android Auto right into your iDrive system, integrate front and rear cameras, experience seamless screen mirroring, and your favorite media playback via USB and HDMI, and so much more. If you wanna know all the nitty gritty details about the MMI Prime and Pro, granted with the older software for now, go check out those videos, link in the description. But this video is all about our newest software update. Now, just real quick, we are always working on improving the software of the MMI Prime and Pro, and any update we have will be available to you for free. If you want the best audio quality, cleanest phone calls, and most intuitive controls of Apple CarPlay and Android Auto with your MMI Prime or Pro in your BMW Mini or Supra, well, this update is for you.
We're not going to cover the process of downloading and installing the update in this video. For that, go check out our last update video, which covers the process in depth. The link for that video is in the description.
First off, why this update? While the MMI Prime and Pro are fantastic with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto integration, they rely on a physical audio connection, and some customers have even reported quality issues with phone calls and answering them. At one point, physical connections for audio were the best. No digital gremlins, no dropouts, no problems. Well, times have changed, and as vehicles are getting older, things are starting to degrade. Aux ports can get dust in them and corrode, physical audio cables can get pinched, cut, bent, and so on. Bluetooth, as much as I hate to admit it as an audio guy, is the way to go with modern vehicles using modern phones and now a modern MMI Prime and Pro. With our newest update, audio from Apple CarPlay or Android Auto will now be sent via Bluetooth, which is going to solve a few problems. Previously, when listening to audio through Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, if you got a phone call, you had to manually pause your song. Now, with this new update, anything you're listening to through Apple CarPlay or Android Auto will automatically pause once you receive your phone call. While it will take too long to get into the technical jargon as to why, you now no longer have to go through the menus of the MMI Prime and Pro to dial in those perfect settings for your phone calls with this Bluetooth update that'll all happen behind the scenes for you. And one last cool feature is when you press the volume knob to mute the system, you're simply just pausing the song now, just like it happens in modern BMWs, which is not something that could happen before. These are just the basics of what make this one of our best software updates yet. For a full list of details, go check out the link in the description of this video. To get this update, that link is also in the description. Now, it's important to note that this software update is completely free, but only available to those with MMI Primes and Pros, starting with a software version of 3. If you have an older version, contact our sales team, and let's see what we can do about you getting set up with a new one. Speaking of setting up, let's get to setting up this update. Again, to show you how to actually put the update onto your MMI, go check out our last video, but once you get that up and running, let's check this out. First thing you're gonna wanna do is actually turn on the function. So in the main MMI menu, go to Settings, go down to System, and then scroll down to Aux Bluetooth Output and toggle that on. And then this is gonna come up. It's gonna say, this option will enable a Bluetooth audio source for Android Auto, Apple CarPlay. The auto switch to aux option in the audio settings will be disabled automatically. Make sure you're connected via Bluetooth in your multimedia system, iDrive. Do you want to restart to apply the changes now? So what does that mean? Well, previously by default, the MMI Prime or Pro sent audio to your BMW through an aux port, either a physical one or a digitally coded one, and your MMI would tell your BMW to auto switch over to the aux as a source so that way you could hear the audio. This stops that auto switch over from happening. Now, the second part is asking to make sure that your phone is actually connected to your BMW's iDrive as a Bluetooth device. Well, why is this important? While there's way more coding and tech stuff to it, the basic gist is your MMI is now receiving the video feed from your phone's Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, and your BMW is now acting as a rather expensive Bluetooth speaker. Now, with all that out of the way, go and hit yes and allow the MMI to reboot. So then you're gonna hold down the menu button again, get your MMI going. All right, so we're good there. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is pair your actual phone to your BMW's iDrive. Now, you might have done this in the past, but I'm gonna show you how to do it from scratch. Right now, I'll show you how to do it on this NBT Evo head unit with iDrive 5 or 6, but then later on, I'm gonna show you on the test bench how to do it with an NBT head unit and iDrive 4. So if you have not done so already, first hold down the menu button on your iDrive controller to get to your main iDrive screen. And then you're gonna go to Media Radio, then scroll down to Manage Mobile Devices. Now it's helpful at this point to just go over to your settings first and make sure Bluetooth is turned on. So we'll just go to settings and we can see right there that Bluetooth is checked. So we'll go back up to connect new device and we'll choose telephone. This is gonna be the easiest way right here. So over on your phone, you'll go to your Bluetooth settings right here and look for this same number. You see this pop up right here. And right now it's gonna pair. Gonna make sure these numbers are the same. We'll hit pair here, okay on the iDrive. All right, and you can see right here, we are connected. Connected for calls and audio. Allow. As you can tell, it works. Now, if you see a message about AAC coding, that's only an Android thing, it's not an Apple thing. You can go ahead and select that if you choose. That's just gonna give you the best audio experience possible with supported apps and audio. All right, so back to mobile devices, we're gonna select our phone, and as you could hear, Bluetooth was already going, but we're gonna wanna make sure that Bluetooth audio is selected, and we're gonna make sure that the phone is selected as our audio source. So for that, you're gonna go back to Media and Radio, and as you can see right here, it is already selected as our audio source. And you can double check in the upper right-hand corner right here, you will see the Bluetooth audio symbol right there, letting you know that your phone is connected and ready for Bluetooth audio. Now I'll show you how to pair your phone on an NBT head unit with iDrive for using our test bench here. The MMI part is exactly the same, so let's just focus on this. So on the main iDrive screen, scroll down to telephone, Bluetooth devices, and choose add new device. Now, once this prompt shows up, go to your phone's Bluetooth settings right here and look for your BMW to appear. Cool, once you press on that, you're gonna make sure these numbers match. You're gonna hit pair here, okay on your iDrive. And we're gonna hit allow right here. And allow one more time. Android users might see the same AAC pop-up as before, so that's up to you. On your iDrive screen, you'll see this pop-up. So make sure telephone 1 and audio are both connected and checked off. Now, a quick note, if you already have a phone paired, you might want to go back to telephone, then Bluetooth devices, hover over your phone and hit option on your iDrive controller, and select configure this device. Now here is where you see telephone 1 and audio once again checked off. While we're here, let's check one more thing to make sure that the Bluetooth audio is gonna work. On the main Bluetooth menu, hover over Bluetooth and then hit the option button on your iDrive controller to bring up this menu. Select configure Bluetooth and make sure that Bluetooth audio is selected. To make sure your phone is selected as the audio source, we're gonna go back to multimedia, external devices, select your phone, and you'll then see the Bluetooth symbol right here in the upper right-hand corner. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is pair your phone to your MMI. This is the same regardless of which head unit you have, so we're back in the F30. So hold on your menu button and we'll go over to the MMI settings. We'll go to connections, and we'll go to pair new device. Make sure your phone is ready to pair in your Bluetooth settings, which we are right here. We're gonna start search. We're gonna see the A20 pop up, which is the phone here. So we're gonna hit stop search. We're gonna select our phone and we'll hit hands-free profile while pairing an Android phone and IAP2 profile when pairing an iPhone. So we'll hit it, we get a pairing request. We're gonna hit pair. As you can see, it's turned red and we're now paired up with our MMI right here. And for CarPlay, you'll just need to accept one more prompt to use CarPlay. You'll see that Bluetooth was connected, but as soon as Apple CarPlay or Android Auto starts, it disappears. Why is that? It's important to remember that the MMI itself is not using Bluetooth. Your phone is connected to your MMI via a Wi-Fi network. It always has been. This update basically allows for two connections. One through Wi-Fi, which will allow the visual aspect of Apple CarPlay and Android Auto to appear on your iDrive screen. And the second is a Bluetooth connection, which will allow the audio side of Apple CarPlay and Android Auto to play through your iDrive system. Is encoding fun? So if you see that Bluetooth connection vanish, don't worry, play some audio and you should be able to hear it. You could also confirm in your Wi-Fi networks that you see the MMI there. But you always want to make sure that in your iDrive settings, your phone is selected as your audio source. Let's go over some basic troubleshooting steps. Say you can't get your phone to connect to your BMW. Go through those submenus in your iDrive settings again. There are a bunch of them and chances are you might have overlooked something that needs to be checked. What if your phone is connected, but your audio is very low, or you have to crank up your volume knob all the way to simply hear anything? Remember that your BMW is now basically acting as a Bluetooth speaker. So take your phone and increase the volume to max, which will send more signal to your BMW. But since BMWs sometimes behave like BMWs, say your phone's connected, everything looks good, you got your volume set to max, and you still don't hear anything, go into your iDrive settings and select a different source, such as radio or aux, and then go back to selecting your phone as a source one more time, and that should fix it. Now, I keep mentioning audio through Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, but a key feature of the MMI Prime is screen mirroring capabilities and audio-video playback via the USB port. But since Bluetooth audio comes from your phone and not the MMI Prime or Pro, if you want to experience audio through that screen mirroring or the USB port, you will need to go into the settings of the MMI and toggle off aux Bluetooth output since that still relies on the aux connection. If you want to use anything plugged directly into the MMI, you simply need to go to your iDrive settings and select aux as your source. No need to go into the MMI settings and toggle off aux Bluetooth output again. What if you have a CIC head unit and one of our MMIs? Well, you know that your audio goes through a physical aux cable. With this update, you won't need that anymore, only if you have a Combox and Enhanced Bluetooth option 6NS from BMW. If you don't, well, thankfully Beamer Tech offers that as a retrofit. So contact one of our sales guys and we'll figure out what you need. And that is how you use Bluetooth functionality in your wireless CarPlay and Android Auto MMI Prime and Pro with the newest software update. It's easy, it's free, and it makes your day-to-day interactions with your BMW and your phone so much smoother, and it makes your vehicle so much more like a brand new BMW. If you have any questions or issues, feel free to give our support team a call and they will be happy to assist. For more tips and tricks, product reviews, and so much more for BMWs, Minis, and Supras, make sure you subscribe and don't forget to ring that bell. Want to know what's happening first? Head on over to our website and subscribe to our newsletter. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok as well. Thanks for watching.